Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's run down some of the announcements from today's Worldwide Developer Conference keynote. So the first part of today's announcements involved macOS 10. And the big reveal was the name of macOS 10.11. It'll be called El Capitan. And it'll include a lot of new usability features, some general stuff, like the ability to use a lot of natural language when doing searches. Also, some neat things like being able to swipe, do swipe gestures in Mail. Also, some really cool new features in Mission Control, like the ability to have this split screen view. You can do a full screen view now, and you can have a desktop with a lot of apps, but this new split screen view looks rather interesting and pretty useful as well. Now, El Capitan is going to be out in July as a public beta. It'll be out today for developers. And then we'll have it sometime this fall. And like all the recent versions of OS X, it'll be a free upgrade for everybody. Now, of course, they also talked about iOS 9. Just like with El Capitan, iOS 9 will be available as a public beta later this summer. Right now it'll be available for developers and we'll all have the free upgrade in the fall. Now a lot of usability features in iOS 9, some really interesting things. Some of the stuff I liked was Siri now will understand the word this a little bit better when you say do something with this, and it'll refer to what you're currently looking at, an email, a message, a location on a map, something like that. There's also going to be some good hooks for developers to be able to hook into search so you can search for something and find an item inside of an app that's not an Apple app, it's a third party app if the developer supports it. Many people have also been predicting for a long time that we'll be able to see more than one app at a time on the iPad, and sure enough we have a split screen view that will be available only with the latest iPad. So the iPad Air 2, of course, it's going to have the processor power to be running two apps simultaneously. It looks like it works very similar to the way the Mac split screen view does. Now, the next part of the keynote dealt with apps. The interesting thing for me was they didn't talk about iOS apps or Mac apps, but just talked about apps, meaning that most of these, I gather, are for both systems. So, for instance, the Notes app is going to have some new features like formatting and the ability to have images and links embedded in notes, even little checklists as well. And the Maps app is going to have a whole new view called Transit, which will have things like, you know, bus and subway schedules and be able to coordinate your movements there. And that's going to launch with only limited cities, and they'll just keep adding cities to it. A new app that was talked about a lot today is called News, and it's basically a news aggregator, not too different than a lot of things out there now like Flipboard, where you'll be able to select news sources or topics and it will show you news for today, and you'll be able to go through them, and then it will customize a little bit more as you select and read different things, and you can also browse. It's going to be really interesting to see Apple's take on this kind of common app genre and whether or not this news app takes over from all the third-party apps that already do it. Of course, now there are three operating systems, and there was a lot of talk about the next version of the Apple Watch operating system called Watch OS 2. Now it's going to include some new features. One of the cool things it's going to have is the ability to use photos as a background for a clock face. I see a lot of people using that creatively, and you'll actually be able to use collections of photos so it switches between them. You'll be able to customize clock faces with more information from different apps, not just what they've got now, and even move forward in time. So for instance, if you've got something on the clock face that shows the weather or say what things you've got coming up today, you'll be able to go forward in time and see those items without leaving the actual clock. There's also going to be a new nightstand mode meant for viewing the Apple Watch while it's on your charger on your nightstand, and some other cool features like the ability to reply to emails on Apple Watch. And the new version of the Watch OS is going to be out for developers now, but it'll be something where everybody else will get it this fall and it'll be free. Apple Pay and Passbook are going to be moving forward. Passbook's going to be called Wallet now, and like before it'll include Apple Pay, but Apple Pay will also have some store credit cards and also loyalty cards, so be able to use it for loyalty cards, not just for paying. So besides the operating systems, the big new announcement was Apple Music. So Apple Music combines what we have now on iTunes, where you can buy music and organize your existing music and create playlists, things like that, with a few other parts. One part is basically what was Beats Music, which is where you can pay a subscription fee. It's going to be $10 a month, and you can stream anything available in the service, which I presume would be everything in iTunes now, although licensing may mean some things are not available in streaming. We'll have to see. You can do it for $10 a month. There's also this great family plan where you can, for $15 a month, have six people in one family have access to it, which is going to be really nice and something I don't see offered, I think, by the other services right now. In addition to that, there's going to be a social media kind of area to this where artists can communicate with fans. Sounds a lot like what was there before with Ping a few years ago. So I have to see how that's a little bit different and how many artists adopt it. And then there's a fourth part, which is Beats One, which is a 24-hour streaming radio station. It's a live radio station with DJs, and everybody will be able to listen to the same thing at the same time and hear new music. Should be interesting to see how many people tune in and how good the station is. So some other notes about Apple Music. They're going to make the first 3 months free for everybody, and then we presume after that there will be no free trial. So we get to try it out starting June 30th for 3 months and see if we want to continue to pay for the service. Also, they're going to be coming out with versions not just for iOS and for the Mac, but they're also going to be Windows and Android versions coming out later this year. And in addition to all those announcements that directly affect the end users, there are a lot of great announcements for developers, like some new developer APIs to allow them to hook into things, the ability to make native apps for the watch, whereas now you have to do it all through the iPhone. There's going to be some cool new graphics engines for Mac and iOS. So we'll see how those affect the apps and the types of experiences that we have as users later on. Let me know what you think of today's announcements. You can, of course, watch the whole thing at Apple's website right now. And I'd like to know which parts you're looking forward to the most.